Hey there, Mom. As your secret Santa this year, I figured not only would I give you a gift, but also show you how big of a gift you are to everybody else in your life. You have touched the lives of many people, both in your family and at school and everywhere else that you go in your life. And I just wanted to show that to you. And so here are some people that would like to wish you a very Merry Christmas.
I love Mrs. Chavis because she's so nice. And she always has a smile on her face and it makes me happy.
Hi, Mrs. Chesney, you have a beautiful singing voice, and you have a beautiful reading voice. Love, Morgan. Merry Christmas.
Alex, what's your favorite part about Miss Chesney being your teacher?
Cool, not cool.
You like cool, not cute? What else? What else does she do?
Read books.
Is she silly?
Mm-hmm.
Does she make you laugh?
Yes.
What else do you like about Miss Chesney?
Means some days we go to PE.
Yeah. What's your favorite story that Miss Chesney reads you? Did you like Curious George?
Yeah.
Does that make you laugh? Okay, can you say Merry Christmas, Miss Chesney?
Merry Christmas, Chesney. Miss Chesney is the best teacher in the whole world. She makes me smile and takes care of me every day. I love you, Mrs. Chesney.
I was fortunate enough to meet Mrs. Chesney when I was 16 years old. She was my mentor, picked me up every Wednesday morning. We went breakfast together, and through her faith and her love for others, she truly inspired me and made such a difference in my life. And now I am so fortunate that she's making a difference in my children's lives. We are so grateful to have you as the teacher for our children. You inspire my children each and every day, and you love and nurture them like no one else. We love you. We wish you a Merry Christmas. Mwah! The Connors love you. Mwah!
Mrs. Chesney, Merry Christmas. These are the things that I think about you. You were nice, you were a good teacher, and these are the favorite moments that I had with you when we were doing the calendar with the whole class. Merry Christmas. Bye.
Hey, Cameron, tell me about Mrs. Chesney.
I love Miss Chesney because she teaches me and she helps me.
Okay, and what else?
And I wish you a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Mrs. Chesney.
Okay, Jagger, what do you like about Mrs. Chesney?
I like that she takes really good care of my brother, and she's like really nice. She gives people a lot of compliments.
Oh.
Like, she gives a lot of compliments to a lot of people. When I say a lot, I mean a lot.
Okay.
I like about Mrs. Chesney because he has the greatest room.
Yeah?
And
what do you think about her?
I like when I waffle.
Yeah, she's very nice, isn't she? She's a great teacher.
Yes.
Yeah. What do you like? What's your favorite thing about Mrs. Chesney?
Well, turns on movies for us.
Yeah. Merry Christmas, Mrs. Chesney from the Stern family. And when I first saw that Max was doing this, I thought, oh, this would be easy because I could talk for hours about how wonderful you are. What I didn't realize was how emotional I would get as a mother who was apprehensive about her youngest going to school. So it's not been as easy as I thought. Anyhow, when I was looking at my hearth, I just thought, oh, that's a perfect example. I have up there things that say joy, love, peace. And I thought that described you perfectly. Anytime we're in your company, it's just a joy. Knox loves being in class. When he started asking to go to school every Saturday made me realize just how much he loved being there and how much he loved you as a teacher and just being in your classroom and in your presence. Peace, I already described a little bit. It was a great peace to me as a mother. When I took him to camp for the first time this summer and he had you as a counselor, he had so much fun. And then when we found out you were his teacher, we were so thrilled because he loved you at camp. And then once we realized how much he loved being there at school, it just brought a great peace for me to leave him there. especially as my baby that I'd had for my sidekick for the last 4 years. And lastly, just love. I just, you know, you give so much love to those children and you can just see it. Just, you know, the way you show them, you love them with your hugs and your patience with them and the way you speak with them and they feel it. And even working as your homeroom ambassador this year, I just really felt encouraged by you and Mrs. Abrahams, and I really can't say enough good things about you. And also I have two angels sitting on my fireplace, and I thought, so that's a pretty good description. We pretty much see you as an angel in our household, and we just thank you so much for all you are doing for Knox and for all the children there. So sorry for my emotional side here, but thank you. We love you.
Tired. We're gonna do this. We're gonna get this done. I have to cram 44 years of friendship into like a few brief minutes. So here we go. We have Barbie dolls and ship clock ice cream truck. You know what that means. And Disney camping trips with the Petlucks and Marshmallow Marsh and crushing pennies on the train tracks and riding Space Mountain with Pam's deafening screams and Laura as quiet as a mouse. And what else? Riding our bikes to St. Clair's and Girl Scouts and Horse Camp and Camp Walaka and being your confirmation sponsor and a bridesmaid in your beautiful wedding to Mr. Chesnes and Windy Gap and Fun and Faith and being roommates at Florida State and the Flat Tire debacle. Going to see Michael Jackson and having our babies and going to the beach and visiting us in Boston. And we are Wawa and Pomelo forever. I'm sorry. It's like 1:30 in the morning and we are getting this done because I love you. And you are forever my friend. Always there for me in happy times and sad, Laura. Faithful, loyal, fun, and always there for any crazy idea that I come up with. You have one of the most giving hearts of any person on the planet. I love you. You are a phenomenal teacher and you love your family and your friends. I am proud to call you my best friend and I love you. Merry Christmas.
My favorite thing about you is when we went to Dillard's and you and Graham taught me about the pink ticket. I love you, Aunt Laura. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Laura.
Christmas. I just want to let you know that I love you a lot as a great sister. I got some great memories of us growing up as kids. I remember sitting in your bedroom listening to Christopher Cross Sailing on your little radio with the turnstile and everything. It was really cool. Just hanging out with my older sister. And then I also remember there were times when we would do dishes together. You would do the wash and I'd do the drying. We'd be listening to the stereo in the dining room, that big console thing that we had. I remember listening to Another One Bites the Dust. Great memory. Remember going to some of your softball games? You weren't a great athlete, so that didn't last very long, but you are a great fan, and I am forever a Florida State fan, so go Noles. No, but seriously, you're a great listener and a confidant of mine, so I really appreciate all you've done for me throughout my life, and I really love you, Laura. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Hope you have a great new year.
Aunt Laura, thanks for being so encouraging to us.
We love you.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Mom. Thank you for being so caring and selfless all the time and being so passionate about your work and your family and always taking care of us. We love you and hope you have a great year. Thanks, Johnny. We love you.
Well, hello there. Laura, you're the wheels of the family wagon. You are the heart and soul of this family, and we wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Laura!
Laura, I'm very happy to have this opportunity to talk about you. You, in my mind, are one of the best mothers I've ever known, and the witness to that is your wonderful son and daughter, Max and Mary, and they've been very, very enjoyable for us as well as I'm sure for you. And I also admire the way you gave up your career at the beginning to stay home to be, well, they were preschoolers, and to be with them and be helping to mold them into the wonderful people they are today. And I'm also very proud of you as a teacher, and I think you must be one of the very best teachers they have over at Benjamin, because this morning coming out of church, Mrs. Barrigo, the grandmother of the children that you have right now, was very, very, very pleased with the job that you do. And we've heard that from many, many people about you. So you should be very proud of your accomplishments with all those lovely little children over there. And that's great. And the third thing is you being my daughter. And that, all I can say about that is that I'm just so happy that you're my best friend.
Well, Laura, Max has asked me to bring up a couple things about you, so I'm gonna do two of them. And these two are some of my favorite memories. The first one was when we lived in Bolton. And the first day that you went to kindergarten, the bus stopped at the top of the hill where we lived, and you ran up the driveway and got into the yellow bus, went immediately to the window, and just waved to Gran and I as you went off to school the very first day. I really think that's when you decided to be a teacher. Now, the second thing that I remember is when you were 17 years old and you were getting ready to go to college, Gran and I put you in our van. It wasn't our van, it was our station wagon with a bicycle, two suitcases and a big box. And we drove down to Fort Lauderdale Airport and put you on a plane to go to New Orleans. I will never forget how they had to box up that bike for you and take the rest of your stuff. So, Merry Christmas.
Well, that's all, Mom. I really hope you enjoyed and know that you are very loved every single day, and know that we are very grateful for all that you do for us. Thank you for watching, and Merry Christmas.